Hola,
Bienvenido a mi canal. Suscribite y dad like si os gusta el video. Hello, welcome to my channel. Subscribe and press like if you like it.
welcome to a practice listening for the GESE6. You are going to hear a talk about rules when going trick-or-treating. You will hear the talk twice. As you listen, write down some notes about what you hear if you want to. I will ask you 6 questions on some facts about rules when going trick-or-treating. Are you ready? Trick-or-treating can be a lot of fun. However, there are some basic rules that need to be followed. Before going trick-or-treating, make sure that everybody uses the bathroom. That way, nobody will have to when they are asking for candy. Another rule is to make sure that adults and children stay together. There are a lot of people out, so it can be easy for a child to get lost. Also, if the children are young, go trick-or-treating nearby, because the child could get tired if you go far away. Something else to think about is that the weather changes, and the later it gets, the colder it can get. For this reason, it is a good idea to dress in layers or bring a coat. Something else that is a good idea is to go trick-or-treating in groups of parents and children. That way, more parents are watching the children and the children are having fun with their friends. Finally, children should never eat any candy or chocolate before they get home. Parents should check the candy and chocolate first, and throw away any that have open wrappers. If trick-or-treaters follow these rules, they will have a safe and fun Halloween. Trick-or-treating can be a lot of fun. However, there are some basic rules that need to be followed. Before going trick-or-treating, make sure that everybody uses the bathroom. That way, nobody will have to when they are asking for candy. Another rule is to make sure that adults and children stay together. There are a lot of people out, so it can be easy for a child to get lost. Also, if the children are young, go trick-or-treating nearby, because the child could get tired if you go far away. Something else to think about is that the weather changes, and the later it gets, the colder it can get. For this reason, it is a good idea to dress in layers or bring a coat. Something else that is a good idea is to go trick-or-treating in groups of parents and children. That way, more parents are watching the children and the children are having fun with their friends. Finally, children should never eat any candy or chocolate before they get home. Parents should check the candy and chocolate first, and throw away any that have open wrappers. If trick-or-treaters follow these rules, they will have a safe and fun Halloween.
Now I will ask you some questions. You only need to answer in a few words.
Question 1. What should you do before going trick-or-treating? Question 2. Why should adults and children stay together? Question 3. Where should you go trick-or-treating if the child is young? Question 4. Because the weather changes, what should trick-or-treaters do? Question 5. Why should parents and children go trick-or-treating in groups? Question 6. Why shouldn't children eat any candy or chocolate before getting home? Now let's look at the questions again, but with the possible answers. Question 1. What should you do before going trick-or-treating? Use the bathroom. Question 2. Why should adults and children stay together? A child could get lost. Question 3. Where should you go trick-or-treating if the child is young? Nearby. Question 4. Because the weather changes, what should trick-or-treaters do? Dress in layers. Bring a coat. Question 5. Why should parents and children go trick-or-treating in groups? More parents watch the children. Children have fun with friends. Question 6. Why shouldn't children eat any candy or chocolate before getting home? Parents should throw away any with open wrappers. This is the end of the listening task.